Hold up.
Yo, what's up, you guys? It's your boy, Darryl Science, and welcome back to Darryl Science Productions. And today, I did in the last video where I showed you guys how to use Share Factory on the PS4. Well, now I'm going to show you guys how to import music onto Share Factory to say you want to put your own music instead of using all that foreign music they give to you. Even though they give it to you for free, it's foreign. But yeah. This video is all about how to import music onto the Share Factory app on your PS4. So, what I do, and why I'm recording you, I would go on YouTube and find non-copyright music. But before I do that, I want to show you guys how I transfer the music from my laptop to the PS4. So, what you want to do, if you have a Chromebook or any kind of laptop or not, you want to go over to the files and put your USB in, which in this case my USB is called Lexer. So what you want to do is make a folder named Share Factory right here, and then in that folder you want to put music or videos. Now this video you can put, I'm going to show you guys how to put music, videos, and images onto the Share Factory app on the PS4. So in the Share Factory folder on your USB, now you gotta make sure the word share is all capped, and the factory can be lowercase. And yeah, in the Share Factory folder, you can put images, music, and videos. That's all you're gonna need to import on the app. So let me show you guys how I get my music. So first off, I would go on YouTube and type in non-copyright music. So just pop up all kind of non-copyright music so you don't get copyright strike. So any of these you want, you just listen to them, and if you like them, you can download them, put them on your PS4, and do them in your video. So right now, say I would use this one right here, the first one. I'm not going to listen to it right now, but yeah, say if I want that one, I would copy the link, and go to a new page and type in MP3 juice. Now I'm not sure if this works on MacBook Pros or not, but I know it works on the Chromebook and any other Windows 10, Windows, any kind of Windows laptop, to be honest. It works on any laptop, but I'm not sure about MacBook Pros. So yeah. What you want to do, you copied the link already from here. Now what you want to do is paste it. Click the search. And just download it. Now you see it downloading. Just wait for it to download. Okay, since this is taking quite a while to download, I'm just going to show you guys the next thing. If you want to do it, you can put it on your flash drive to put on your PS4. So, images is the next thing. Say if you want to put, I don't know, a funny picture or whatnot. I'm going to just go with this. This looks pretty funny. Not really. Just saying that. So yeah, you want to click on it. You wanna double tap. If you don't have a mouse, you wanna double tap on it and then save image. That would download as well. So yeah, save that. And it's already downloaded. So yeah, and then videos. You can do them the same way as the music. Actually, no, you can't. No. So yeah, for the videos, I actually have something downloaded. I actually have some downloaded on my laptop to just download the video, the whole video. So what I just do is click on download and it will download. But if you guys don't have this, I forgot what it's called. I'm not sure though. And if you guys don't have that, you can go on a website called Video Converter Online. I'm gonna put a link in the description down below if you guys want it. So yeah, it's called Free Video Converter Online. And that's what it looks like. So you get to convert the video. You convert the video from a video to audio file. But yeah, you just want to download it. And all kind of stuff keep popping up. But yeah, you just want to download the video. Yes. Click on that. And then again, you would copy the link. And then you would paste it over here so that it would download. So yeah, we're still waiting on the music file to download. This is a big file. I mean, it's not really a big file, but it's just taking forever. So yeah, as you saw, I downloaded the image which said LOL I'm Batman. So what you want to do, you just want to drag it from your internal storage. You want to drag it all the way to the folder you created with ShareFactory, and you want to put it on images if you created an image folder in the ShareFactory folder. So you want to put it there. That shouldn't take a long time. So yeah, now it is in the image folder on your ShareFactory folder. But yeah, and now we're still waiting on this music download. But yeah, we don't really have the tip to watch that download. So basically what you want to do is when it downloads in your internal storage, wherever it downloads on your internal storage, you want to drag it, bring it over the music folder, which is in your ShareFactory folder, and put it right in here. And it should be in here somewhere. But yeah, now I'm going to show you guys how to import it from the laptop to the PS4. So let me just switch over. Alright, so basically now we're on my PS4 on the ShareFactory app. So basically I've taken my USB from my laptop and put it into the PS4. So right now, to import the music, all you gotta do is scroll down to import content, click on import music, and then it should show up like this. And then you wanna scroll down to import from USB, click on it, and then the music should pop up, which is, it's right there. You wanna press X and press square so it will import. Just like that. And once I'm done showing you guys the rest, I'll show you guys with how you can access it within a video. So let's go on to how to import the video now. Now the video is what I recorded from my laptop. So you want to go to import videos, you want to click on it, then just like the music, you want to scroll down to import from USB. It should be the same method all the time with anything. So there's the video what I recorded from my laptop. So you want to press X on it, and then you want to press square to import it. And yeah, it's imported now. So now let me show you guys how to import the images. It's the same process for every import of video, music, or images. So I'm just gonna show you anyway. So you wanna scroll over to import images, click on it, and then scroll down to import from USB once again. Then the image should be there. See it there, boom, LOL I'm Batman. That's a cute little baby anyway. But anyway, yeah, you want to press square and it should import just like that. So now, let me show you guys how you can access it. So let me go to new project. Yeah, I don't care which one I click. So yeah, how you access them, all you want to do is press for the music. All you want to do is press X, scroll over to add music, and the music should be right there, which is best non-copyright music, what I just imported. So you want to, add music, you want to press X, and it should just pop right up. It'll just take a while to load in, but yeah. Now, the video, what I imported from my laptop, all you have to do is press X, then scroll over to add clip, and then the video should be right there. You press X, and you press square to add it on. So yeah, that's the video right there. And so now, how to add a image. So this one was really complicated for me in the beginning when I started editing. So what you want to do is press X, go to add overlay, and then go to import images, and there it is. I'm LOL, I'm Batman, so yeah, I don't know what the hell I did. Okay, add images. You want to scroll down to add images, press X, and then, yeah, it should pop up right there. But the only thing is, it cannot be a separate, like, clip. Like how the video clips are separate all the time. The images you import cannot be separate. So, but yeah, you say if you want to do a funny moment in the video, you can just by adding these images. Say, I don't know what some of these images would say, but just like that, say if I'm playing an Injustice video, I could put this baby up, say LOL, I'm Batman, and say if I win, but yeah, something like that. I don't know what you guys would do. You could be creative with it. But yeah, that's basically all you need to know, how to import images, music, or videos from your laptop or desktop to your PS4 on to the Share Factory app. So hopefully this video helped you guys out a lot. Hopefully you guys enjoyed the video. Please give it a huge thumbs up if you guys really enjoyed this and it helped you out a lot. Please comment down below, what did you think about this video? Just comment anything you want, I don't know. But yeah, and also subscribe to my channel if you're new and if you want daily content like this. Until the next one, I will see you guys in the next video. Peace.